So, hi friends. So here we have to solve a numerical based on complex number. So what is given? So here I raised to z is given as z, where the value of z is given as x plus I, where which is obviously a complex number, and we have to prove that the I raised to z, or I would say the square of mod of I raised to z, is equal to e raised to minus 4n plus 1 pi y, where the value of n is given as 0, 1 and 2. Now guys, the question is how to solve this given numerical. So let's observe one thing. So z is given as x plus I y. This is the given relation. So let's start with that. So first of all, I'll write that I to the power z is z, where z is x plus I y. So I would say this is I to the power x plus I y is equal to x plus I y. And guys, here it becomes easier to identify. So on the right hand side, there is a complex number in standard form, one real, one imaginary part. And on the left hand side, there is a complex number in the form complex number raised to complex number, which I have explained to you in the previous problem. So whenever we have complex number raised to complex number, we follow certain steps. So step number one is convert this base or the number, complex number which is in base, in the exponential form, and the complex number in the exponent or the power in the Cartesian form. So already this number is in Cartesian form, I just have to convert this I into exponential form. So we have seen this value of I in the last video, so I'll rewrite that value here. So it is cos of pi by 2 plus I sine pi by 2. So this is the value. Now guys, this is the polar form. Now I said that I want this in the exponential form, and for that we will say it is e raised to I pi by 2. You will put it here, and guys, there you will make the mistake, because you have not seen what is required. So let's see the required term. So in the required term, we want n. Now guys, what is n? So value of n is given as 0, 1, 2, but what is n, or how to bring that n in the question? Because then only we'll be able to get the answer. So if you put this value, that is e raised to I pi by 2, directly over here, we are never gonna get n in the solution or in the given problem. So we have to bring that n, and that n has come from the general polar form. So guys, it means we have to add 2n pi in this given polar form, then only we'll be able to create this n. So here I'll say that it is equivalent to cos of 2n pi, I'm adding, so 2n pi plus pi by 2 plus I sine the same angle over here. Now guys, this value 2n pi plus pi by 2, this is the general polar form, that is cos of this theta plus I sine theta, this whole become general polar form. And now we will convert this general polar form into the exponential form. So that will become, here I'll rewrite the value, e raised to I, it is 2n pi plus pi by 2, which is the theta, new theta, raised to x plus I y is equal to x plus I y. Now we have to multiply these two values. So let's simplify this here itself. So 2 into 2n, that is 4n pi plus pi upon 2. I can take pi outside. So 4n plus 1 and pi by 2 outside. So here I'll say it is e raised to I 4n plus 1 into pi by 2 and x plus I y, as it is equal to x plus I y. Now guys, it's done, almost done. We have to just multiply these two powers by using the mathematical formula, a raised to m raised to n, that is a raised to mn. So we'll multiply these two terms. So when I'll multiply this term with x, you'll get the same result, that is imaginary part, and x will be added. So here I'll say it is e raised to I 4n plus 1 pi x by 2. And here this term into this second term, so I into I is I square, which is minus 1. So that will become minus this term into y. So here I'll rewrite, that is minus 4n plus 1 pi y by 2, which is equal to x plus i y. Now guys, let's solve this. So here we will get e raised to, now I'll separate the terms. So this will be e raised to minus 4n plus 1 pi y upon 2 into e raised to I 4n plus 1 pi x upon 2 equal to x plus I y. Now guys, this number is again in the exponential form, which I can convert it into the polar form. So first term as it is, that is e raised to minus 4n plus 1 pi y upon 2, and this will be cos of 4n plus 1 pi x by 2 plus I sine 4n plus 1 into pi x by 2, and this is equal to x plus I y. So guys, now this left hand side has also got converted into a standard form of complex number, that is one real part and one imaginary part. And since there is an equal to sign between two complex numbers, we can compare the real part and imaginary part with imaginary part. So here I'll say equating real and imaginary part, therefore the value of x equal to e raised to minus 4n plus 1 pi y by 2 into cos of 4n plus 1 pi x by 2. Similarly, the value of y, that is the imaginary part, is e raised to minus 4n plus 1 pi x by 2. So we got x and y. Now guys, let's go back to the question. So here it is said that the square of mod of I raised to z. So we should know the value of I raised to z. So I raised to z is this value. Here I raised to z is z. So z was x plus I y. So x is this and y is this. So now what we have to do is we have to take mod of I raised to z. So it means it is a mod of z. So here I'll say, therefore mod of I raised to z is equal to mod of z, and mod of z means it is mod of x plus I y. And guys, it is nothing but square root of x square plus y square. So if you take square root on both sides, then we can get the value. But if you check the question, then in the question we want square of that mod. So therefore I'll take square on both sides. So therefore it will become mod of I raised to z the whole square equal to mod of x plus I y the whole square. And therefore the square root and square will be cancelled, and we will get the square of these terms, that is only x square plus y square. So here I'll write it is equal to x square plus y square. So what is x square plus y square? It is square of this plus square of this. So this is, when I do the square of this, this 2 and 2 will be cancelled. You will get it as e raised to minus 4n plus 1 pi y into cos square of this plus y square. So again, this e raised to minus 4n plus 1 pi y into sine square of this. And guys, from these two terms, we can take e raised to minus 4n plus 1 pi y common, and cos square theta plus sin square theta is 1. So it means we got the value, and if you check, then it is the exact value. So here we have proved this result by using the exponential form of complex number. Now guys, I am very sure that you like the method of explanation and the complex number different numericals. And if you want to follow, or if you want to learn more numericals on engineering mathematics, then stay tuned on ekira.com, where you can find me and my videos in one order, and you can enjoy mathematics unlimited. Thank you very much.